Well, good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to the North Greenville Sports Network. You are looking live at Pepsi Stadium in Tigerville, South Carolina, the home of the North Greenville University Crusaders. North Greenville University, where Christ makes a difference. Thank you for joining us for this week's edition of Conference Carolina's Men's Soccer for tonight's contest between the home team, the North Greenville Crusaders, and the visitors from Emmanuel College with the Lions. Emmanuel comes into this game 1-2 on the season and are currently sitting in sixth place in the Conference Carolina standings. To update you on how their season has gone, they opened up their season a few weeks ago at home against Belmont Abbey, but fell 1-0 after 90 minutes. Then they took on Barton College a couple weeks ago, and after tying the game 2-2, they unfortunately lost after the first overtime period. However, last week they went up against King University, and from one goal in each half, they won the game 2-0. So the Emmanuel College Lions, coached by Coach Tim Starr, will be looking for a victory today. On the flip side, we have the North Greenville men's soccer team in his first season as the head coach, Andrew Olick. So they come into this game 1-1 on the season and are currently sitting in fourth place in the Conference Carolina standings. After a 1-0 loss in double overtime to Chauhan University 3 weeks ago, they came back last week and blew away the competition in a 6-1 win over the Mount Olive Trojans, with goals coming from Coletta Matate, Brady Carmichael, Carlos Navarro, and the man of the match, Gareth Green, the number 9, in a fantastic hat trick of goals. So there were a lot of goals in the last game, and North Greenville and Coach Andrew Olick will be looking to get the job done today with a win, and of course the attack and the entire team looking to get forward and score and pounce on the Lions often and fast. So now you see both teams are getting ready to hop onto the field and prepare for the announcing of the starting 11s, and after the invocation and the national anthem, I'll update you guys on the starting 11s for both teams, and throughout the game I'll update you guys on live stats as well as the score. And of course, be prepared and ready for hopefully an action-filled and packed game between these two very good opponents. And as I said, North Greenville comes into this game sitting fourth place in the Conference Carolina standings, and Emmanuel comes into this competition in eighth place. So knowing those two stats, both of these programs are looking for victories today, and on the flip side for North Greenville, they'll be looking to continue their success from last week, and Emmanuel also comes into this game looking for a victory after they beat King University last week. So as you see, both teams are walking out onto the field now and preparing for the national anthem, the invocation, and the announcing of the starting 11s for both teams. And like I said, throughout the game, I'll update you on live stats, the scores, and be prepared and ready for an action-packed game between these two amazing programs.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Pepsi Stadium here on the campus of North Greenville University, where Christ makes the difference. Today's matchup features the Lions of Emmanuel College taking on your North Greenville Crusaders. Let's go ahead and meet the starting lineups for today's match. First for the visiting Lions. In goal, number 1, Giuliano Palma. Defender number 2, Albert Bajrami. At defender number 4, Derek Fournier. At defender number 5, Joel Pope. At forward number 7, Sean Walder. At midfield number 8, Shane Cronin. At forward number 9, Will Fraser Gray. At midfield number 10, Harrison Wright. At midfield number 13, Christopher Ramos. Midfield number 16, Kevin Fitzgerald. And a defender number 19, Alejandro Nestares. The Lions are coached by Tim Starr. He's assisted by Alexander Reynolds. And now, the starting lineups for your North Greenville Crusaders. In goal, a senior from Cleveland, Georgia, number 1, Noah Kendrick. Number we thank you for this beautiful day you've blessed us with. We thank you for the opportunity to come out and enjoy the great sport of soccer. Lord, we ask that you keep these athletes safe during the game and that they honor you with the talents that you've given them. In your name we pray, amen.
And that was your national anthem and the invocation, as long as the starting 11s were also announced. And speaking of starting 11s, let me take you through both teams, starting with Emmanuel College. In goal, you see number 1, Giuliano Palma. Defenders, number 2, Albert Bajrami. Number 4, Derek Fournier. Number 5, Joel Copes. And number 19, Alejandro Nestares. In the midfield, we'll see a couple outside backs with number 7, Kian Walder, and number 14, Luke Jones. And in the midfield, we'll see several good players as well, including number 16, Kevin Fitzgerald, number 13, Christopher Ramos, and number 8, Shane Cronin. And another additional midfielder in there is number 10, Harrison Wright. And leading the Lions is number 9, Will Fraser Gray. He has no goals yet this season, but he has 2 assists so far. And now for the North Greenville Crusaders. We'll see a very similar lineup, but one specific change, and it's a good change for the North Greenville Crusaders, benefiting from a very good game from them from last game. So in goal, Noah Kendrick. He has no clean sheets yet this season, but he had 7 saves in the last game against Mount Olive, including a PK save. And listen to this. He has 193 career saves for the Crusaders. So a very good goalkeeper in goal, also behind a very good back line with no changes to this back line, and they've only allowed 2 goals in the season, and they've been very good. Dylan Erkins, Brad Jennings, David Cake, and Michael Lamb. Into the midfield, we'll see Angel Miranda as the holding mid, with Jorge Henao-Chica and Carlos Navarro more attacking. And up top, there's no Renan Makulia, but Kaletsa Matate comes into his place. On the right, he scored a goal and had 2 assists in the last game. Gareth Green up top, the senior striker from Navarre, Florida, the number 9, scored a hat-trick in the last game, and has 19 career goals on his career for North Greenville. And Connor Hall on the left, the junior from Rock Hill, South Carolina. So now we are underway here in Tigerville, and North Greenville will have the ball first. They're kicking from right to left, and Emmanuel will have the ball in the second half as they will start this half attacking from left to right. So now here's Brad Jennings on the ball for the Crusaders, and now he finds his CDM, Angel Miranda, to the graduate student Jorge Henao-Chica, the midfielder out of Bogota, Colombia. Now Dylan Erkins on the ball for the Crusaders. Carlos Navarro gets past the man, and he finds the senior captain, Kaletsa Matate, scored a great goal in the last game to add to the lead in a big 6-1 win over the Mount Olive Trojans a week ago for Andy Olick's side, and their first of the season under him. Here's the freshman, David Cake. And now Chica again. Navarro sends the ball forward, looking for Matate on the right side, and he's going to get there as he takes on the Italian defender, Albert Bajrami. Kaletsa Matate gets the ball in the box, and it was almost headed in by the Colombian midfielder. And now Michael Lamb gets it back in the box, and now he finds Gareth Green, and complaints from the Crusaders looking for a foul, but no foul given, and Palma will get the ball and boot it forward for the Lions. And he finds Will Frazier Gray, the number 9. But he gives it away, and now it's in the possession of the Crusaders once again. Lamb to Miranda. Freshman out of El Paso, Texas, is the starting midfielder for these North Greenville Crusaders today. Here he is again. Here's Carlos Navarro. He scored his first goal of the season a week ago off of a penalty kick that he won in the first half. So now it'll trickle out for a goal kick after Connor Hall was taking on the defender for Emmanuel, Derek Fournier, and he does his job and shields the ball out of play for a goal kick. That'll be taken by number 1, Giuliano Palma. Palma's a sophomore out of Napoli, Italy. And this is his first season with the Emmanuel Lions. Goal kick forward finds the head of Connor Hall. And now Jorge Henao Chica wins the ball back for the Crusaders, but only gives the ball away after a pass that couldn't quite find Dylan Erkins. So now it'll be a throw-in for Emmanuel that'll be taken by Albert Bajrami. Here's Frazier Gray. Now he finds Nastarez, the freshman, taking on David Cake. Nastarez, Miranda's there for the Crusaders. And now here's Matate on the right side, and after the ball deflected off of Bajrami, it came off of Matate in the end, and it'll be a throw-in for the Lions. This throw will be taken by number 7, Kian Walter. Erkin sends the ball forward, looking for Gareth Green, but he can't quite find him. But it does find the head of number 5, Joel Copes, for the Lions. Here's Miranda, trying to get past the midfielder, Shane Cronin. And now Fitzgerald finds Cronin, who finds Frazier Gray. And now Gray plays the ball over the top, and he finds his teammate, who has a shot, but is well wide of Noah Kendrick's goal. That's number 10, Harrison Wright, who scored a big goal for the Lions in the last game they had a week ago against King University. Here's Navarro. Navarro playing the ball forward, trying to get to Connor Hall, but it's a little too far for him to handle, so it'll be a throw-in for the Lions. And again for the Lions, after the header away by the graduate student out of Southampton, England, Michael Lamb, number 12. Here's the throw-in to be taken by number 13 for the Lions, Christopher Ramos. Now Gareth Green running onto it, taking on Derek Fournier. And Gareth Green keeps the ball in play, looks for a ball in the box, and he does cross it, but it's deflected out and well defended there by number 4, Derek Fournier, and it's out for the first corner of the game for the Crusaders. Carlos Navarro takes it short quickly, finds Gareth Green, and now he switches the play and finds Connor Hall. Now Michael Lamb and Emmanuel did their job there with the pressing from number 7, Kian Walter, and now North Greenville will continue to possess the ball as Brad Jennings sends a long ball forward, looking for Connor Hall on the left side, and he finds him, and Will Frazier Gray, the number 9 for the Lions, is back to defend, and now it'll go out for another corner. Well, as I mentioned, this North Greenville team scored 6 goals a week ago, and the man on the ball right now, Carlos Navarro, who's about to send the ball in the box, scored 1 goal, and the man next to him, Coletta Matate, also scored. So here's a corner in by Carlos Navarro, headed away by Joel Copes, and away by Fitzgerald, and back in. And the goalkeeper, Palma, comes out and collects well. Here's Palma sending the ball forward, but only finds the feet of David Cake, and he will keep the ball for the Crusaders as he finds his left back, Michael Lamb. Henao Chica. Jennings finds Cake. Now here's Navarro carrying the ball forward for the Crusaders. He finds Henao Chica again, the Colombian midfielder. Sends a nice ball forward looking for Dylan Erkins, who does win the ball and does really well there to keep the ball in play. Not only keep the ball in play, but the AR initially called for a third for the Crusaders, but it'll be a third for the Lions. But great job there by Dylan Erkins. It very well could have been a goal kick, but he kicks it out to the right side, and it deflects off the corner flag, and it stays in for a throw-in. And now the Crusaders will get the ball back for a throw-in that'll be taken by their senior captain, Dylan Erkins. And now he tells his teammates to get in the box as he has a decent throw as well. Long throw in the box. Bajrami clears. He finds Miranda in the center, and now he finds Michael Lamb on the left side. Lamb finds... Well, Connor Hall was there, and his first touch unfortunately let him down, and it went through the defense, and it falls into the hands of the Emmanuel goalkeeper, Giuliano Palma. And his ball forward finds the head of Carlos Navarro. And Joel Copes does a good job there, the senior defender for Emmanuel. And here's Copes again. Joel Copes is a senior from Bainbridge, Northern Ireland, and his previous school is the Georgia Military College. Lamb finds the El Paso, Texas midfielder, Angel Miranda. Looking for Gareth Green, and it's good defending there by Albert Bajrami, the junior defender from Ravenna, Italy. And his previous school is York College before he came to Emmanuel College and into this Emmanuel Lions men's soccer team. So now here's a throw-in on the right side for Dylan Erkins to take. He hurls it into the box, looks for the head of Kaleta Matate, and he got the touch, and unfortunately it went out of bounds for a goal kick that'll be taken by Giuliano Palma. He tells his teammates to get forward, and looks like he'll have another long ball to look for one of his midfielders. And he does get a long ball forward, and it finds the head of Fitzgerald, who finds Shane Cronin, but Connor Hall takes it away from him. And now Bajrami finds his outside wingback, Walder. And after good defending there by Nestares, it's going to be a throw-in for the Crusaders. Well attacked there by Angel Miranda to get the header in front of number 16, Luke Fitzgerald. And now it's going to be a foul by the Northern Ireland defender, Joel Copes, and it's going to be a free kick for the Crusaders. Gareth Green was the man fouled, and Gareth Green goes into this game with 3 goals in the season, and all 3 goals he scored came in the last game a week ago against the Mount Olive Trojans in a phenomenal hat trick that earned him not only the man of the match, but he continues to show why he's the number 9 in this program, as he has 19 career goals for the Crusaders in his career. So now here's Gareth Green on the left foot. His shot is blocked by the wall, and Keen Walder clears for the Lions as Brad Jennings takes on Will Fraser Gray, and the ball is now into the feet of Noah Kendrick, who comes into this game very confident as well. After only allowing 2 goals in the season and no clean sheets just yet, as I mentioned, he has 193 career saves for the North Greenville Crusaders in his now 4th season as a senior with North Greenville. Here's Navarro carrying the ball forward for the Crusaders, looking for options, and he gives it to Jorge Henao Chica, who finds Jennings and now Cake on the left side of the defense for the Crusaders. Now Miranda plays forward and he finds Gareth Green, who tried to bring it under control, but the ball was a little heavy. And Nestares finds Walder on the left side, and he gives it back to Nestares and back to Walder. Walder carrying the ball forward, getting past Miranda on the left side. Now he looks for Will Fraser Gray, and it's a good tackle there by David Cake to win the ball back for North Greenville. Shane Cronin. Cronin is another very experienced player in this Emmanuel side, as he is a senior from Cork, Ireland, and has been with the program for a few years now as well. Here's Lamb. Navarro now finds Green. Lamb. If you tuned into the last game for the Crusaders, you could tell that Andy Ollick, as the head coach of the Crusaders, loves to keep possession, and this team in white loves to do that, and you're seeing that on display here now. And now Carlos Navarro finds Michael Lamb with a great through ball, and now Lamb goes for goal. Well, initially I thought he was going to cross the ball into the box, but it ended up being a little trouble there for a second for the goalkeeper, Palma, but he dealt with it well, and it's going to be out for a corner kick for the Crusaders. Good save there by Palma. Otherwise, it looked like it was sneaking into the top corner and it would have been the first goal of the game. So now here's a corner to be delivered in by Carlos Navarro, and he finds the head of Gareth Green, who flicks it over, and again. And now it'll be cleared away by the defender for Emmanuel, as Brad Jennings has time on the ball and will look to continue to keep that possession that his coach loves to see. Here's Matate. Green. Well, his first touch let him down there, and it'll be a throw in now for the Lions, to be taken by the left back, Bajrami. So now from the ensuing throw-in for North Greenville, Dylan Erkins finds Brad Jennings, who finds David Cake, and switches the field now to his left back, Michael Lamb. Back to Cake. Jennings looking for options forward, and he does play the ball forward, but only finds the feet of Nastarez. And his clearance finds David Cake, who plays his senior goalkeeper from Cleveland, Georgia, Noah Kendrick, graduate from White County High School. Here's Jorge Henao-Chica, the graduate student, with a good switch of play there, and he finds Michael Lamb. And now Miranda plays the ball forward, and he finds Connor Hall with a great pass, and he flicks it up in the air, trying to get Michael Lamb in on the act, but can't do so. And now Shane Kernan, the midfielder for the Lions, will get it cleared. And now Lamb with a good ball back to his goalkeeper, Noah Kendrick, again. Given away by the Crusaders, but they win it right back with Jorge Henao-Chica, who finds Gareth Green, and he gets in between defenders with a great move there, and he finds his South African teammate, Kletso Matate, on the right side, looking for options in the middle. Crosses the box, and it deflected away by Albert Bajrami. It deflected out off of him, but Palma kept it in play and will get his team forward as he punts the ball to the left side, and it finds his teammate, number 19, Alejandro Nastarez. And now here's a chance for the Lions to keep possession as Bajrami finds Palma again. Here's Derek Fournier. Fournier, the junior defender from Phoenix, Arizona, who transferred from Arizona Western College. Now here's Harrison Wright. And Connor Hall with a good tackle there for the Crusaders, and it wins the ball back and gets the ball into the feet of Navarro, who finds Jorge Henao-Chica, and now the El Paso midfielder, Angel Miranda. Lamb switches the field and finds Henao-Chica again. Erkins. Now Navarro looks for options forward. Closed down there by Will Fraser Gray, but Navarro switches the field and now finds Lamb. Lamb sends the ball forward, looking for Matate, and Fortier will walk with the ball and watch it roll out of bounds for a goal kick. Well, so far, folks, we're 15 minutes into the game, and there's 28 minutes left to go in the first half, and no goals, but there have been a couple chances, and the majority of them have been to the North Greenville Crusaders, but have unfortunately not been able to convert just yet. So here's the goal kick from Giuliano Palma, the Italian goalkeeper for Emmanuel, and the header by Carlos Navarro means it's going to be a throw-in for the Lions. Here's Cronin. Ramos taking on Connor Hall, and Connor Hall deals with it well, and it will lead to a throw-in to be taken by Michael Lamb, his senior English teammate. Miranda. Navarro. Lamb again. That's a good tackle there by Harrison Wright, who is a sophomore midfielder from Bournemouth, England, and transferred into the Emmanuel College from St. Peter's Secondary School. So now Brad Jennings sends the ball forward looking for Connor Hall. Good header away by Christopher Ramos. And now Navarro gets the ball back into the possession of North Greenville. Miranda again. Carlos Navarro, a lot of touches for the midfielders today for the Crusaders so far. And Navarro looked like he was looking for Gareth Green there, but it was a little to his left, and it'll fall into the hands of the goalkeeper, Giuliano Palma, who boots the ball long, and it's a very good punt by Palma, and it finds the feet of Will Fraser Gray, but his first touch let him down, and it goes back into possession of the Crusaders. Now Miranda looks forward. Connor Hall attacking the ball, looking for a way to get the ball back, and now Jorge Henao-Chica kicks the ball out for a throw-in for Emmanuel. Henao-Chica has not scored yet for the Crusaders this season, but has recorded some very good statistics, as Will Fraser Gray is now getting forward for the Lions, and he finds Kean Walter, who finds Harrison Wright on the right side, tries to cross the ball in, and now Michael Lamb with a good defensive play to clear the ball away for the game's first corner for the Emmanuel Lions. First corner of the game will be taken by number 16, Kevin Fitzgerald. Outswinging delivery finds the head of number 2, Albert Bajrami, but it's well over the bar of No Kendrick's goal, and it'll be a goal kick for the Crusaders. Here's Miranda for North Greenville. David Cake now finds Miranda again. Lamb plays Jennings, and looks like Emmanuel are not being too excited to press the ball too much. Looks like they're letting North Greenville possess the ball and do their thing with possession in their half, and when they come into their half, they take care of business by closing down the space. But now here's Kaletsu Matate on the right side, getting past one, but not getting past Bajrami. And Shane Cronin clears the ball away for the Lions. So now it's a throw-in for the Crusaders on the right side to be taken by the right back, number 7, Dylan Erkins. Long throw in the box, finds the head of Gareth Green, who flicks it on. Cronin clears. And now it's back at Green's feet, and he has a shot, and it's just wide. Well, Gareth Green had the initial flick in the box, which was cleared away by Cronin. And from the deflection by Jorge Henao-Chica, it found Gareth Green's feet again. And he had a good first touch and had a good shot on his left foot, but it was just wide of Palma's goal, and it'll be a goal kick for the goalkeeper to take. Header there by Angel Miranda, and he finds his teammate Michael Lamb, but now Miranda kicks it out of play for a throw-in to be taken by the right back, number 13, Christopher Ramos. Ramos is a junior midfielder from Canton, Georgia, and is a graduate from Cherokee High School. Here's Miranda again. And now the referee blows a whistle for a foul, looks like on Shane Cronin, on Angel Miranda. But first, the referee is pulling both players to the side because it looked like after the referee blew the whistle, there was a little extracurricular play there by Miranda as he was kicking away at Cronin there. So caution is issued to both players as the free kick will come for the Crusaders, with David Cake finding his captain, Brad Jennings. Definitely need to be careful if I'm the North Greenville Crusaders. Last week there were several yellow cards issued in what was a good victory, but there were a few yellow cards and even a red card issued, as in the last game we saw a couple of cautions issued to David Cake, who fouled striker number 9, Alfie Pope, the number 9 for the Mount Olive Trojans. He fouled him in the box for the resulting penalty kick, which was saved in a great save by Noah Kendrick. And there's also yellow cards issued to left back Michael Lamb, center midfielder Carlos Navarro, and Ryan Parker is serving a 1-game suspension for a red card that he picked up from getting 2 yellows. So if I'm the Crusaders, I would be very careful in this game too. So now the clearance from Joel Copes means that Brad Jennings gets the ball back for the Crusaders, and he finds Henao-Chica from the resulting play. And he gets a great ball out wide to his right back, Dylan Erkins, who draws the foul from the left back, Albert Bajrami, the Italian defender. And it looked like that was a painful one for Dylan Erkins to deal with, but Bajrami helps him to his feet, and the referee now will caution Bajrami. No yellow card, but again, just a warning as he gave to Angel Miranda and Shane Cronin just a few minutes ago. So now it's going to be a free kick for the Crusaders on the right side. Navarro and Green will be standing over this, and Dylan Erkins will be to their right. Navarro sips over the ball. He finds Green, who finds Dylan Erkins on the right side, serves the ball, and great defending there, both by Harrison Wright and not only Harrison Wright, but looks like number 19, Alejandro Nesnarez for the Lions. So now it's going to be a corner for the Crusaders on the far side that's going to be taken by the senior Kaletsa Matate. It's a decent ball in the box, and it finds the feet of Angel Miranda, who takes a touch in the box, trying to get around Bajrami. Still Miranda. And now the clearance by Will Frazier-Gray. And it's going to be nice and easy for David Cake to deal with, who has a lot of time on the ball and space too. And he'll find his center midfielder from Buga, Colombia, Jorge Henao-Chica. Kick again. Navarro sending the ball forward for Gareth Green. Can he get to it first? Yes, he can. Gets a great ball in the box. Looks for Kaletsa Matate, and it was nearly there for him. And Kaletsa Matate holds his head in his hands as he knows that was a good opportunity for North Greenville to get on the board first. So now Emmanuel deals with that ball, and Brad Jennings finds Noah Kendrick, who finds David Cake. And North Greenville will continue to keep possession here with 18 and a half minutes to play in the first half. Still scoreless here in Tigerville, but a few good chances so far for the Crusaders and a couple shots for Emmanuel as well. So now David Cake looks forward and he has a great ball forward, finding his senior captain, Kaletza Matate, and that'll be good defending there by number 19, Alejandro Nastara. Excuse me, that's number 13, Christopher Ramos. So now Michael Lamb plays Carlos Navarro back, and Navarro looks for Gareth Green on the far side. And now he finds Connor Hall. And that was Jorge Henao-Chica on the right side there, rather than Gareth Green, who is in the middle. But the AR on the far side calls the offside and raises the flag for a free kick ensuing for the Emmanuel Lions. Palma sends the ball forward. It finds the head of number 14, Luke Jones. And now the clearance forward finds the head of Derek Fournier, who finds Michael Lamb. And now Kaletza Matate brings it down, but back in the air again to Gareth Green. And here's Lamb again. Looks for Connor Hall, who's chasing the ball down, trying to keep it in play, but he was taking on Christopher Ramos, and Ramos dealt with it well. And he shielded the ball out for a goal kick. Palma with another goal kick to be taken in this half, as he's had several already, with the ball staying on this end of the field for the majority of the game so far. Good flick there by Alejandro Nastarez, as he takes on Angel Miranda, and Miranda does really well there to get around him. And now, looks like Miranda was trying to keep the ball in play, and despite the ball deflecting out off of Nastarez, the referee blew for a whistle first, so it looks like it's going to be a throw-in for the Lions. But not before a substitute comes into the game for Emmanuel, with Will Frazier-Gray coming out, and it looks like number 8, Shane... Excuse me, not Shane Cronin, but the substitute coming into the game for the Lions, for one, is number 11, Michael Blakely, who is on the ball now, and he finds his teammate Shane Cronin. Alejandro Nastarez. And now there's going to be a foul there by the central... the right back for North Greenville, number 7, Dylan Erkins. And he stays on the floor, but it'll be a free kick for the Crusaders here in just a second. The other substitution coming onto the field for the Lions, besides Michael Blakely, is number 6, Charlie Hill, who scored a goal and has one goal this season so far. So he will be looking to add that tally as Emmanuel has a free kick opportunity here from the left side with 15 minutes left to play in the first half. And as you see, the Emmanuel players are ready, but Noah Kendricks continuing to get his wall set up and organized. So Walter leaves it, and it's going to be Fitzgerald to take it. And now he sends it into the box, but it's comfortable for Noah Kendrick to deal with, and he calms his team down and sees his options, and he rolls it out to his senior captain, Brad Jennings. Dylan Erkins. Back to Jennings, and now finds Angel Miranda in the midfield. Cake. This North Greenville back line continuing to look for their options forward, but at times, as you've seen throughout this game, they've had to settle with continuing to pass back and forth between outside back and center back. And now that's a risky pass there by Lamb, and was good pressure there by Mastarez, but North Greenville gets the ball now with Gareth Green finding Kalitza Matate, who had the shot from the left side, but it'll be a ball that'll trickle out for a goal kick. Well, good build up there by North Greenville as Gareth Green was found there by David Cake. Green had a great through ball in behind and in between Fournier and Christopher Ramos, and it found Kalitza Matate, who had a shot with his left foot, but it was wide right of Giuliano Palma's goal. So here's another goal kick for the Italian goalkeeper. Matate wins the ball back for the Crusaders, and Gareth Green gets there too, and he finds his freshman center back, David Cake. Michael Lamb. And now Chica. As I mentioned earlier, expect a lot of possession from the Crusaders throughout this game, and you've definitely been able to see that they've done that throughout this first half here in Tigerville, as Henao Chica finds, or was looking for Michael Lamb there, but it does find the feet of Michael Blakely. And Connor Hall with a good tackle there to win the ball back for the Crusaders. Here's Erkins on the right side. Navarro. Looking for Matate, who tried to get a touch, and Albert Bajrami will let the ball roll out for another goal kick to be taken by Palma. Palma looking for Fitzgerald, but it finds the feet of Nestares, who was looking for his teammate on the other side there. Looked like number 14, Luke Jones. But it'll go out of play for another throw-in for the Crusaders. So now here's another spell of possession for the Crusaders as Jennings finds Cake. And now Henao Chica gets the ball again for the Crusaders. Lamb, good ball down the line to Connor Hall. On the left side, now he finds Gareth Green. Green with another good through ball, finds Kalitza Matate in. Oh, if he just got a nick to it, it might have beaten Palma, but Palma got the ball first, and it'll be another good opportunity wasted by the Crusaders, but Giuliano Palma will be grateful that the ball ended up in his hands as he punts the ball forward and looks for Luke Jones on the left side there. And now Henao Chica wins the ball for the Crusaders and finds David Cake again. Jennings. Here's the number one, Noah Kendrick, who made 7 saves a week ago against Mount Olive, including a PK save, and also has 193 career saves in his time with the North Greenville men's soccer program. Here's Joel Copes. Bajrami taking on Navarro, and Navarro pressing him well on his back and wins the ball back as Miranda finds Navarro, and Navarro plays it back to Erkins. And now here's Henao Chica. Great ball by Henao Chica, and it finds Gareth Green, who's onsides. Cutting inside of Bajrami, trying to get a shot on target, and Gareth Green gets the shot off, and it's another easy save for Palma. Well, good work there by Gareth Green on the right side, cutting inside of Bajrami and getting past Joel Copes too, but the shot deflected by a defender and found the hands of the goalkeeper, Giuliano Palma again, who's been pretty busy so far in this first half, but has been equal to everything that the Crusaders have thrown at him. Here's Matate. Erkins. Now Carlos Navarro. And now David Cake brings the ball forward for the Crusaders, looking for options forward, and he does send the ball up, but it's too far ahead of his front line, and Palma will be grateful again that the ball ends up in his hands. Now here's Michael Blakely for the Lions. And he was trying to find Christopher Ramos, but the ball was a little behind him, so it'll be a throw-in for Michael Lamb to take. Miranda. Jennings. Switches back to the other side and finds his center back partnership in David Cake. Jennings finds a great ball to Dylan Erkins, the right back from Greer, South Carolina, and a graduate of Wade Hampton High School. Jennings finds Erkins again. Erkins looking for Matate, but can't quite find him, but he gets the ball back from Bajrami, and now Luke Copes clears. Luke Jones clears, excuse me. Charlie Hill with a good header, and so too Brad Jennings, and so too Kevin Fitzgerald. And now Henao Chica gets the ball for the Crusaders, and he finds his goalkeeper, Noah Kendrick. Well, folks, 7 minutes here to go in the first half in Tigerville, and there's still no score between these two sides, who have been pretty even so far, but the chances have gone mostly to the Crusaders. And so far, nothing has gone in the net, but they've had good chances that they've been close to taking. So now here's Navarro for the Crusaders. Green. Lamb finds Connor Hall, who's onsides. Gets a cross with the left foot, and it's cleared away by Jill Copes. Another throw in by North Greenville, and another spell of possession as they continue to keep the ball and continue to control this game in the first half, the North Greenville Crusaders do. Now Navarro sends the ball to the right side, and he does find Dylan Erkins, but Bejrami is there, the Italian defender for the Lions, to clear it away, and it'll lead to another throw in for North Greenville. Erkins sends the ball in, looking for a Henao Chica. And the clearance away by Luke Jones means this is another throw-in for Erkins. Erkins with a long ball in the box. Finds the head of Angel Miranda. But his header only finds the hands of Giuliano Palma once again. Palma again with the long ball forward. It's a really good punt. Well, I'll tell you what, folks. He can send the ball about two-thirds to three-fourths of the way beyond the midfield line if he gets a really good punt, as you just saw there, folks, with Giuliano Palma, who so far this season for Emmanuel College has done a pretty good job in goal. He kept a clean sheet last week against King University, and he made 5 in the last game and has made 14 on the season thus far. So now the defending that was well done by Bajrama means that it's going to be a throw-in for Dylan Erkins. Green, defended by Kevin Fitzgerald. So now here's Carlos Navarro, gets a ball in the box, and it's a poor clearance by Fournier. And now Henao Chica was looking for an overhead kick opportunity, but was shied off the ball. And now Dylan Erkins plays his fellow senior captain, Brad Jennings, who finds David Cake, and now Noah Kendrick will get the ball back in play for the Crusaders. Jennings to Cake again. 3.5 minutes to go and still no goals here in Tigerville. But so far, North Greenville not only has controlled possession, but they've had the better chances as well. Here's Green. Good tackle there by Jennings and the deflection out off of Luke Jones means it's going to be another throw in for North Greenville. And now Chica. Looks on the left side, and he does find his left back, Michael Lamb, who's made a good run, taking on Michael Buckley. He gets a ball in the box, and Bajrami clears. And Angel Miranda tried to get the header to continue to keep possession with his team, but his pass only finds the feet of Alejandro Nestares. And the deflection out off of Navarro means it's going to be a throw-in for the Lions, but not before another substitution comes into the game. Here's Connor Hall for the Crusaders. He finds Gareth Green in the middle. Matate finds Michael Lamb with a good overlapping run. And here's the cross in. It's a good save by Palma. Well, good run there up from the back was Michael Lamb, the graduate student from Southampton, England. But his cross only found the hands of Giuliano Palma. And with a minute and a half here to go in the first half of this game, it looks like it might be a scoreless first half, but we shall find out as Blakely now has the ball for the Lions. And there's the substitute just coming into the game for the Lions, and it's number 24, Steve Ramirez. Steve Ramirez, the sophomore from Snellville, Georgia, and a transfer from Georgia Gwinnett College. Here's Joel Copes. Steve Ramirez came in for, looks like, Will Fraser Gray. So now a foul is given away by Emmanuel, and it's going to be a free kick for the Crusaders that will be taken by Dylan Erkins. Angel Miranda. And now Chica. Gets the ball forward, looking for Kalitza Matate, but good header away by Derek Fournier. Lamb and Henao Chica now giving the ball back and forth to each other, and now Christopher Ramos clears the ball forward. And he finds the head of Jennings. Here's Luke Jones. He finds Steve Ramirez as a substitute. But he gives the ball away, and it finds Brad Jennings, who finds Michael Lamb, and now Noah Kendrick clears the ball away for the Crusaders. And now he tried to get the ball from the freshman, Alejandro Nestares, and that'll be a foul by Green. And as you hear the horn, that means it's the end of the first half here in Tigerville. So scoreless between these two sides, North Greenville 0, Emmanuel 0, and as I said earlier, the majority of the chances have gone the way of the Crusaders, and the majority of the possession, as well as North Greenville, has controlled the game thus far. So halftime stats for you guys, obviously no goals and no assists. North Greenville recorded 9 total shots with 5 of those on target, and Emmanuel had 2 shots and 0 on target. 4 corners for the Crusaders and 1 for the Lions. 3 fouls were recorded by the Lions and 2 by the Crusaders. The Crusaders were called offsides once. And no saves so far for Noah Kendrick, but all the work has been done in goal by Giuliano Palma with a lot of goal kicks, as well as 5 saves. So those are your halftime stats, and your score once again from Tigerville. North Greenville 0, Emmanuel 0. These two teams are going to take a break, and we'll take a break right with them, as we will come back here in just a few moments for the kickoff of the second half here in Pepsi Stadium from Tigerville, South Carolina. And welcome back here to Tigerville, South Carolina. You're looking live in Pepsi Stadium, the home of the North Greenville Crusaders, for today's contest in Conference Carolina's men's soccer between the home team NGU and the visiting Emmanuel Lions. Thank you for tuning in to us with this second half. And we come into the second half off of a scoreless first half. No goals between this team, but the majority of the chances went to North Greenville. And, of course, North Greenville has controlled and possessed the most in this game. So, going into this half, both teams are looking to get on the score sheet as this is a 0-0 game so far. And the Emmanuel Lions will have the ball in this half to start out. So they will attack from right to left, and the Crusaders will be attacking from left to right. And this half is very important for both of these programs as North Greenville is going into this game 1-1 on the season, and of course, Emmanuel going into this game 1-2. So both of these teams are hungry for a win, and we'll see what happens here in what is expected to be an action-packed second half. Everybody's ready. We're just waiting for the referee's whistle. And now we are underway here for the second half in Tigerville as Kevin Fitzgerald gets the ball forward for the Lions. And the left back Bezrami will let the ball roll out of play for a throw in for Emmanuel. Bezrami will find the striker up top, Kian Walder, and there will be a foul there by Angel Miranda, and it'll be a free kick on the left side to open up this first minute of the game, of the second half for the Lions. So now Noah Kendrick will set up his wall for the Crusaders, and looks like in that wall will be Jorge Henao-Chica and senior captain Coletto Matate. So Kian Walder and Kevin Fitzgerald will stand over the free kick for the Lions. And it'll be an in-swinging free kick, and it's just over the head of the Emmanuel players, and Michael Blakely sends it back in the box, and it's a good save there by Noah Kendrick to get the ball back in the possession of the Crusaders as Brad Jennings has the ball, and he'll find his freshman teammate from El Paso, Texas, Angel Miranda. Michael Lamb's first touch of the second half finds the deflection via Michael Blakely, and it'll be a throw-in for Lamb to take. David Cake finds Brad Jennings, his partner center back on the right side of the defense. Back to Cake. North Greenville will continue to keep possession in this second half as they did for the majority of the first, but this half hopefully we will see if they can find the net with their attack that scored 6 goals last week against Mount Olive as Brad Jennings finds a great ball to the left side with Connor Hall. He has Michael Lamb on his outside. He chooses not to use him. And Connor Hall trying to get around the defender Christopher Ramos, but Ramos does his job to shield the ball out of play for a goal kick that will be taken by Giuliano Palma. Palma with that big left foot of his will boom the ball forward and will look to find one of his teammates, and it does find the head of Shane Cronin initially, and good defending by North Greenville leads to a throw in for Emmanuel. Here's Kevin Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald, the sophomore midfielder from Ross Cria, Ireland. Now Derek Fournier. Looking for Blakely, and good defending there by Michael Lamb. And that'll be another throw-in for the Crusaders. The Lions, excuse me. Miranda with the header, and again. And then Navarro's header finds Fournier. And the ball will roll out of play again for a Lions throw. Well, Christopher Ramos threw the ball into Kevin Fitzgerald there, and he looked to find Blakely on the right side, but it's a little over his head, so it'll be a throw-in for Michael Lamb and the North Greenville Crusaders. He finds Gareth Green, who is shoved in the back there by Christopher Ramos, and it'll be a free kick for North Greenville. And with the ball trickling to the right side, that means Emmanuel can organize their defense and set up for this free kick that'll be taken by Michael Lamb. Here he is. Brad Jennings. Dylan Erkins with his first touch of the second half. Kaletza Matate. Gareth Green looking for Matate again, but Bejrami is there for Emmanuel to defend really well, and Erkins will win it back temporarily, and Bejrami is there again. Here's Lamb. David Cake finds his captain Jennings as we continue to see this little spell of possession for the Crusaders. Hinachika was looking for Lamb there on the left side, but it was a little over his right shoulder, and it'll be a throw in for Emmanuel. Blakely taking on Michael Lamb, and now Angel Miranda will win the ball back temporarily for the Crusaders, and good work by him leads to a throw in for North Greenville. North Greenville trying to get a goal in this half to go 2-1 on the season after they opened up conference play a few weeks ago against the Chawan Hawks and unfortunately fell here after a 1-0 double overtime loss. But they came back last week and blew the competition out of the water, Mount Olive. They beat the Trojans 6-1 with goals coming from Kaletza Matate, number 14, number 10, Carlos Navarro, number 21, Brady Carmichael, and a hat trick from the number 9, Gareth Green. So they will be looking to score in this half to add to that tally of goals and, of course, add to their win streak. Here's Navarro for the Crusaders on the left side, taking on Ramos. Cuts inside of Ramos, now cuts back. Navarro trying to get a ball in the box, and it's blocked away by Ramos, and he does his job. Connor Hall gives it back to Carlos Navarro. And Navarro will go down, and there's a foul by Michael Blakely. And Blakely is confused, but he knows that he tripped him, and it'll be a free kick for North Greenville on the left side, just outside the 18-yard box. So now it's Giuliano Palma's turn to organize his wall as Carlos Navarro will be standing over this free kick for the Crusaders. Another opportunity on a set piece here for North Greenville to get on the board first in this game. Well, Carlos Navarro was about to take the free kick, and now the referee stops play to talk to Kevin Fitzgerald and Angel Miranda. Another caution for Miranda in this game, as earlier in the first half, he and Shane Cronin got into a little dispute, and the referee settled it between them. Now the ensuing free kick from Navarro. It's a good ball in the box, and Palmuck punches it away. Very well done by the goalkeeper. And it finds the feet of Michael Lamb. Here's Henao Chica. Gets a ball in the box, looking for Gareth Green, and it didn't quite find him. It was a good clearance there by Joel Copes. Lamb again. Play the ball back in the box, and Palma will retrieve again. Good initial punch there by the Italian goalkeeper as the ensuing free kick was right inside the six for him to deal with, and he dealt with it well. Another big, long ball forward by Palma, and it finds Kian Walder initially, and Michael Blakely gave it away to the midfielder for North Greenville, Carlos Navarro. And now here's Kevin Fitzgerald to Christopher Ramos. Now Navarro plays the ball forward, looking for Coletta Matate, and the ball deflected out, and it finds Coletta Matate, who finds the net! Coletta Matate, the South African sensation, scored in the last game, and he gets his second of the season today with a fantastic goal. What a strike to get the North Greenville Crusaders on the board first in the second half of this crucial Conference Carolinas game. North Greenville 1, Emmanuel 0. Here with 35 minutes left to play in the game. But what a goal by Coletta Matate from a great ball over the top by Jorge Henao Chica. And as I mentioned, that's Coletta Matate's second goal of the season and his first today. North Greenville 1, Emmanuel 0. It was powered and lashed into the net by the right winger from Johannesburg, South Africa. So now Emmanuel get the ball back in play, and Christopher Ramos will find his center back, Derek Fournier. Ramos now will find Blakely, the pacey striker, continuing to move and trying to meddle through the North Greenville defense, but Michael Lamb clears. Coletta Matate now has two goals in the season and, of course, two assists to come with that as well. He's a very prolific player and, of course, a very big impact player as the senior captain of these North Greenville Crusaders. And it also took a lucky deflection there after the ball from Jorge Henao Chica found Derek Fournier, and the deflection from Christopher Ramos found the feet of Coletta Matate. And he powered into the net past the Italian goalkeeper, Giuliano Palma. So now here's Jorge Henao Chica again. Here's the goal scorer, Coletta Matate. And number 10, Harrison Wright, with some good defending, and the ball out of bounds will lead to a corner kick for the Crusaders. And now Chica sends the ball into the box. And it finds the head of the other senior captain. And that's Dylan Erkins. Well, your senior captain, Coletta Matate, had a goal literally a few seconds ago from a great ball over top by Jorge Henao Chica. And Henao Chica now sends the ball into the box off the corner. And right to it, straight to it first, is number 7, the right back, Dylan Erkins. And now your score from Tigerville in Pepsi Stadium. With Dylan Erkins' first goal of the season, North Greenville 2, Emmanuel 0, and what a great second half start by the Crusaders in the first 15 minutes of the second half. They get two goals, and Jorge Henao Chica with two assists, one great ball over top to find the feet of Coletta Matate, who powered it into the net past Giuliano Palma. And now off of a set piece, the set piece does the trick for the Crusaders with a great delivery from Jorge Henao Chica, and it's powered in by the senior right back from Greenville, South Carolina, Dylan Erkins. And now it's 2-0 North Greenville as the substitute coming in for the Lions, Will Fraser Gray, gets the ball down and tries to get it for Noah Kendrick. And now Will Fraser Gray trying to get the ball, trying to intimidate Noah Kendrick. And now Fraser Gray will get a warning from the referee because Will Fraser Gray knows better. And Noah Kendrick has a wry smile on his face because he knows, why are you doing that? He's asking, why are you doing that, man? So now Kendrick finds David Cake on the left side. Fitzgerald plays the ball forward, and he finds Shane Cronin. And now Michael Lamb will send the ball out of play for a free kick, or a throw-in, excuse me, for the Lions. Here's Cronin. Cronin with the shot and a good block there by Angel Miranda. And now Bajrami looks for his outside winger, Kian Walder. And now Jennings with the header. And he finds Alejandro Nastar as the freshman. Here's Blakely trying to get a shot off, and a great tackle there by Michael Lamb, the graduate student from Southampton, England. And now here's Will Fraser Gray trying to get in the box for Lions, but it only finds the feet of Kalitza Matate, and his clearance will go out of bounds for an Emmanuel throw-in. Joel Copes finds Derek Fournier, his partnered center back from Phoenix, Arizona. Fournier will send a long ball forward looking for Will Fraser Gray, the substitute, and No Kendrick will now hold the ball, and North Greenville with a 2-0 lead here in the second half. Folks, if you're just tuning in, the Crusaders went into this half scoreless, 0-0, and then they opened up the first 15 minutes with two goals, two assists for Jorge Henao-Chica after he found a great ball to Kalitza Matate over the top of the Emmanuel back line. And Kalitza Matate, South African sensation, fired it into the net past the goalkeeper Palma. And the second goal came from a great corner delivery by Henao-Chica just a few minutes ago. And it found the head of the man who just headed the ball, Dylan Erkins, who gets his first goal of the season for North Greenville. Erkins again with the header. Matate. No handball call by the referee, and Matate continues to play as Bajrami on the ground, but Matate tries to get past Walder, and Walder defends really well. And now Walder throws the ball in off of the ensuing throw-in. Fournier. Blakely. Blakely dribbling, trying to get beyond Angel Miranda, but Miranda says, I don't think so. And Miranda's there again, defending against Blakely. And now Shane Cronin was trying to find number 10, Harrison Wright, who's making a good run there off the ball, but good defending again there by the Crusaders. Fournier will kick the ball out of bounds, and that'll be a throw-in for North Greenville. But not before a substitution to come into the game, and that is the freshman from Kernsville, North Carolina, and a graduate of Northwest Guilford High School, and that's number 24, Max Huber. His first minutes of the season for the Crusaders at CDM, taking Angel Miranda's place. Here's Fitzgerald for the Lions. Sending the ball forward, and a good defending there by Dylan Erkins. Here's Max Huber in his first touch of the game. Carlos Navarro. And now the yellow card will come out of the pocket from the referee, as that'll go to number 19, the freshman for the Lions, Alejandro Nastarez, on the foul on Carlos Navarro. He looks confused, but the referee says, you know what you were doing, so here's a yellow card for you. So that's the first caution of the game for either of these teams. And as I said, that's the freshman, number 19, Alejandro Nastarez, the freshman from Cadiz, Spain, for the Lions, who received that yellow card. So now a free kick for North Greenville to be taken by Brad Jennings here with 30 minutes to go in the second half. Good header away there by Joel Copes. And now Huber finds Navarro, and Navarro finds the goal scorer, Dylan Erkins. Here's Gareth Green, trying to get in behind the defense, but good tackle there by Joel Copes. And now Huber gives the ball away, and he finds number 7, Kian Walder. Still Walder. Good defending there by Brad Jennings, and now David Cate clears. Here's Fitzgerald. Cronin. Fournier. Blakely. Good defending there, but it goes back to Blakely. And Max Huber with a great challenge. Just off the bench a few minutes ago, is called straight into action. And also coming into the game in his first touch of the half is number 31, Arthur Santana, who sees his first minutes on the field for the Crusaders since the Chihuahuan game a few weeks ago. Another center midfielder, just like Angel Miranda from El Paso, Texas. And Arthur Santana graduated from Coronado High School. The El Paso boys have done a good bit of damage so far this season for the Crusaders. And, of course, Arthur Santana now seeing minutes in this game as well. So here's the long throw for Dylan Erkins, and it finds Gareth Green. And now Gareth Green is tripped up there by Joel Copes, but no call by the referee. And from the long ball forward by Emmanuel, finds the head of Brad Jennings. And now Carlos Navarro gets the ball back from Kaletsa Matate. Here's Matate again out on Fitzgerald, so it'll be another throw-in for the Crusaders. So two substitutes coming in for the Crusaders that just came in. Number 24, Angel Miranda, Max Huber for Angel Miranda, and number 31 there on the left side for number 17, Connor Hall, is Arthur Santana. So now a throw in for the Lions on the right side here with about 26 minutes to go. And the referee calls it back for an illegal throw, and he'll be allowed to take it again. And the ball is given away to Michael Lamb, and he finds Jorge Henao-Chica, the man with two assists in this game. One assist for the goal for Kaletsa Matate to open up the game and put the Crusaders in front. And then a few minutes after that goal, Henao-Chica had a great delivery in the box for the second goal of the game that was headed in by number 7, Dylan Erkins, as number 7 for Emmanuel gets the ball in the box, Kean Walder, and now Alejandro Nestares had the ball at the top of the box and had the chance to shoot. And that shot says, the referee says that shot took a deflection, so it'll go out for a corner for the Lions here with 25 minutes to go. These Crusaders trying to maintain this 2-0 lead and, of course, trying to get their first clean sheet of the season. So far, no clean sheets in a 1-0 loss a couple weeks ago to Chihuahuan and a 6-1 win last week against Mount Olive. So they'll be looking to keep their clean sheet intact as Fitzgerald sends the ball in the box, cleared away by Dylan Erkins. And the shot came in from Nestares. Here's Walder. Huber with the clearance, and Lamb backs him up and clears the ball for sure. Here's the throw-in from Nestares. Flicked on by Derek Fournier. And now it's Santana on the ball, finding his left back, Michael Lamb, who clears the ball forward, and the ball goes out for a Emmanuel throw-in. Here's Blakely getting the ball in the box, looking for Nestares, who gets past Brad Jennings. And no foul called there by the referee, and he tells Nestares to get up. And now Christopher Ramos will let the ball roll out of play for a throw-in for the Lions. Matate. And now Chica finds Huber. And Huber looks on the right side and he finds Carlos Navarro, who keeps the ball in play. No, says the referee. He said that the ball trickled out of bounds and it'll be a throw-in for the Lions.
Go, go, go.
And now David Cake with the ball to Henao Chica, but he finds the feet of Alejandro Nestares, who is right there to pressure him as soon as he took a touch. Good header away by Brad Jennings. And now Shane Cronin finds the ball forward, and it's a great ball to Kian Walder, but great recovery by the goal scorer, Dylan Erkins, who had that goal just a little while ago off of that great corner kick delivery by Jorge Henao Chica, and he powered the ball into the bottom left corner to give the Crusaders the 2-0 lead. So now here's the ensuing corner from Kevin Fitzgerald, here with 23 minutes to go in the second half. Headed away by David Cake. Following up on it is Michael Blakely for the Lions. And now Shane Cronin with the ball in, cleared away by Max Huber. And Arthur Santana with a poor touch, and Nestares had the shot. It was blocked away by the Crusaders. Now Matate. And the ball forward by Shane Cronin was deflected out off of Christopher Ramos, and now the ball will go out of play for a throw-in for North Greenville. And now some more substitutions coming into the game, and Angel Miranda comes back in, and he's substituted for Jorge Henao Chica. So Henao Chica makes way for Miranda. And also coming into the game, coming in for Dylan Erkins, is number 5, his first minutes of the season, Sam James. He's a graduate student from Tredegar, Wales, and transferred over from Erskine College. So now David Cake is moved over to right back. Brad Jennings is the right center back, and now Sam James is the left center back, getting his first minutes of the season for the Crusaders. Here's Matate off the pass from David Cake. Now Navarro. Cuts inside of Copes and Barami. And now Navarro will kick the ball out of play because he realizes his senior captain, Kaletsa Matate, is down and hurt. So we'll see what happened with him, but let's hope that Matate is okay. And Matate is still down, and his teammate Angel Miranda looks like he's stretching his hamstring, so it might be a little strained there to his right hamstring. Matate gritting his teeth and looks like he's in a bit of pain, but it's good to see that his teammate Miranda helps him to his feet. And it looks like Matate will continue here as the throw-in will come in now from the Lions. Now Kendrick finds David Cake, and Cake plays the ball to the guy who just came on back to his feet. And that's Kaletsa Matate, who scored the first goal in this game off of a great ball forward by the man who just substituted a minute ago, Jorge Henao Chica. And Kaletsa Matate powered the ball into the net past the goalkeeper, Giuliano Palma. And Miranda with some defending to do against Nestares, and he defends really well. And now Navarro still for North Greenville, looks for Gareth Green. Now Shane Cronin. And Will Fraser Gray, the number 9, gives the ball away for the Lions as Joel Copes fouls Gareth Green, and he tells him to get up, but the referee stops play, and he's reaching to his pocket, and that'll be a yellow card for Joel Copes. So with 20 minutes here to play in Tigerville, North Greenville is still up 2-0 on the Emmanuel Lions. And now coming into the game is another substitution for the Crusaders. As Kaletsa Matate will come out to make sure that he is okay. And he's played a fantastic game so far for the Crusaders. And back into the game comes number 17, the junior from Rock Hill, South Carolina, Connor Hall. Here's Michael Lamb, the left back for the Crusaders. Arthur Santana. And now here's the giveaway, and it finds the feet of Gareth Green, but Unfortunately, he couldn't do anything with it, and it would be a goal kick for the Italian goalkeeper, Palma. Palma with another ball forward, and he was looking for the head of Shane Cronin, his senior center midfielder from Cork, Ireland. And now here's Michael Blakely. Blakely finding Alejandro Nestares, and now he looks for Will Fraser-Gray. But Will Fraser-Gray can't quite get to the ball as it was a little over past there, and it'll be a goal kick. Noah Kendrick with this goal kick for the Crusaders. As Arthur Santana wins the ball for North Greenville and goes down from the challenge by Christopher Ramos. So it'll be a free kick for North Greenville here with 19 minutes to go here in the second half, as North Greenville is looking to not only win this game to go 2-1 on the season, but to get their first clean sheet of the year as well. So now Sam James with the ball out to the right side as he was looking for Connor Hall. But good defending there by Albert Bajrami means it's going to be a throw-in for David Cake and the Crusaders. Gareth Green. He had a hat-trick last week against Mount Olive. No goals today, but 19 career goals for the Crusaders. Now here's Ramos. Lamb goes down from the challenge, but the referee says no foul, keep playing. Lamb is still down as Blakely continues to play on. Miranda is in the way. And now he's looking for his friend El Paso, from El Paso, Arthur Santana. And now the referee calls play back for Michael Lamb as he is down and continues to stay down. Michael Lamb having a few words there with the referee and Coach Andrew Olick telling him to calm down there to make sure he doesn't get carded. And now Lamb gets up and shakes hand with Christopher Ramos and play will now continue. So now Angel Miranda with a good throw down the line, looking for Gareth Green, and the ball still stays in play. And Gareth Green was looking at the referee, expecting him to point the other way, but the ball is in the possession of the Manuel Lions with Derek Fournier. And now Lamb clears forward. Fournier again. Here's Cronin. And Miranda gave the ball away there looking for Max Huber as Blakely plays the ball forward and looking for Alejandro Nestares. Gets past David Cake, and now Noah Kendrick will come out of his goal and make a good save to deny Nestares and keep his clean sheet intact. And now Nestares is down. Well, good ball over top there as Will Fraser-Gray was also involved. And he found the feet of Alejandro Nestares, who got past David Cake. And that touch, though, was a little heavy. And because of that heavy touch, it allowed Noah Kendrick to come out of his goal and claim the ball. And that's why Nestares is down right now for the challenge by Noah Kendrick on him. Nestares getting medical attention from the trainers from Emmanuel College. And let's hope that Nestares is also okay. So Alejandro Nesnarez, the freshman from Cadiz, Spain, who graduated from Soto Grande International School, will make way and he'll head to the bench, and a substitution will come in for him. So now Noah Kendrick will put the ball down and get the ball back in play. And it looks like the substitution that came in for Nesnarez is number 10, Harrison Wright, who has one goal in the season for the Lions so far. So now the free kick will result for the Lions as Shane Cronin, their captain, will take over and will stand over this free kick. Cronin with the long ball forward. It does find the head of Joel Copes, looks like, and he goes down, and it'll be a free kick for the Lions right on the edge of the area. Well, this is a good opportunity for the Lions to get back in the game here with 15 minutes to play, as the Crusaders have led 2-0 for the 75 minutes of play we've had so far. And the foul in the area means it's going to be a free kick and a good opportunity for the Emmanuel Lions. Noah Kendrick will set up his wall and get them organized to hopefully block this free kick coming in from Luke Fitzgerald, who stands over the ball for the Lions. So now it's Fitzgerald on the right foot, and it's a good save by Noah Kendrick, and it's more comfortable than he might have thought it would be. So as he gets the ball in his hands, he tells his teammates to get forward, and he'll get the ball up in the air looking for Connor Hall, but it does find the feet of Shane Cronin. Frazier Gray, who steals the ball away from him, is Brad Jennings. And now Noah Kendrick will look left and find a great ball out wide to Arthur Santana. And now Harrison Wright putting in some work for the Lions, but his first touch will lead to a throw in for the Crusaders. Clearance by David Cake, way up in the sky, and it is looking for Gareth Green. And the ball out of play means it's going to be a North Greenville throw-in off of the Emmanuel defender. And a few plays ago, there's a substitution that came in for North Greenville. Out comes Carlos Navarro, and in comes the freshman, number 18, Samuel Ojo. Ojo is a freshman from London, England, and a graduate from Millfield School. Here's Arthur Santana. Lamb. Green. Trying to get past Shane Cronin, but he wins the ball back. And Gareth Green still, and he goes down. And but the referee says play on, and Sam Ojo with his first touch of the half. But unfortunately, it's going to fall right to Harrison Wright, and here's Emmanuel on the counterattack with Blakely and Walder on his right. Here's Blakely now. Blakely had the shot, and now it's Keegan Walder, and here's the goal for Emmanuel College, and now they're right back in this game with 12 minutes to go, and obviously no Kendrick's very upset with his defense there. But good build-up by Emmanuel to respond in the second half as they get their goal. Harrison Wright had the ball initially and was driving with Walder and Blakely on his right. Wright played the ball out to Blakely, and Blakely crossed the ball in, and there was Kian Walder with now his third goal of the season for Emmanuel College. And near score from Tigerville now. North Greenville 1, North Greenville 2, Emmanuel 1, here with 12 minutes to play. And now Santana will play the ball forward, looking for Connor Hall, but it'll fall into the hands of Giuliano Palma. And it's going to be a frightening finish here in Tigerville for the Crusaders, folks, as the Crusaders will not have their clean sheet today, but they could still have their 3 points that they're looking for here with 12 minutes to go. Here's Shane Cronin. Albert Bajrami. Nice little move there past Sam Ojo, and it finds Shane Cronin again. Brad Jennings with the clearance. Finds Arthur Santana. Miranda. Ojo. Looking for Angel Miranda again. And Miranda stepped on Bajrami's foot, and Bajrami is complaining that there should be more involvement with the referee on that play, but the referee says no yellow card, just a free kick. So here's the ensuing free kick by number 8, Shane Cronin, as he will send the ball forward for the Lions. Great ball in the box, finds the head of Sam James. And Michael Lamb will clear for sure. Here's Christopher Ramos. Finds Michael Blakely. And now Michael Lamb with a great tackle and pressure on his back, and it'll lead to a throw-in for Emmanuel. Blakely will be offsides. Nice play there by Emmanuel, and Kean Walder was complaining there for a second to the referee, but Blakely was in an offsides position, and it'll be a free kick for the Crusaders with 10 minutes to play here in Tigerville. So Sam James with a free kick here for the Crusaders, looking for the head of Connor Hall. And now the good defensive work by Christopher Ramos leads to a throw in for North Greenville. So now the ball will roll out of play. Derek Fournier lets it go for a goal kick that will be taken by Giuliano Palma, who gives it back to Fournier. Fitzgerald. Green with the tackle, and he wins the ball back for the Crusaders. And he finds Arthur Santana. Santana looking for Gareth Green on the right foot, and it's blocked by the Emmanuel defense and cleared away by Emmanuel. Here's Kean Walder. Bajrami. Will Fraser Gray gives the ball away to Max Huber. Fitzgerald getting the ball forward not once but twice, but only finds Angel Miranda. And now Harrison Wright with a great tackle there on Angel Miranda's blind side. Here's Blakely getting forward for the Lions. Megs Angel Miranda. But does it matter because Sam James is there, and Blakely with the foul, and that could very be another yellow card for the Lions. And let's see what the referee does as Sam James continues to stay down. That was a good defensive play by him to get the ball back for the North Greenville Crusaders, but Blakely brought him down and can stop the counterattack from happening. Here's Connor Hall on the left side taking on Christopher Ramos. Santana. Santana looks for Angel Miranda in the center, and it'll be cleared away by Bajrami. Harrison Wright. Now it's Max Huber. Huber will find Ojo on the right side, taking on Bajrami. Still Ojo. And the referee calls a foul there, and several NGU players, as well as the fans, are very confused. But Bajrami cheers as if he scored a goal, saying, thank you for the free kick. So now he'll send the ball forward for the Lions, and he'll look for his number nine, Will Fraser Gray. And now it'll be a free kick for the Crusaders for the foul by Fraser Gray on Brad Jennings. So 7 minutes to go here in Tigerville, and the score is still 2-1 North Greenville in this Conference Carolinas matchup. Brad Jennings sent the ball forward and was looking for Gareth Green, but now the ball falls to the feet of David Cake, who plays Jennings back. He'll clear it out of play for a throw-in for the Lions. Substitution coming into the game for Emmanuel. And not only with the change, it looks like a change in substitution from what I'm, a change in formation from what I'm hearing from the Emmanuel players. So not only a substitution for the Lions, but also a substitution for the Crusaders, as it looks like number eight, Jorge Henao-Chica, comes back into the game. The man with two assists in this game, one off of the great strike from Kalota Matate with his ball over the top, and Henao-Chica also sent in a great delivery from a corner that found the head of Dylan Erkins, as Harrison Wright now has the ball for the Lions, and he finds Michael Blakely, who finds Luke Fitzgerald, and the clearance by Sam James off of the substitute, number 19, Alejandro Nestares. So now Nestares will tell his teammates to get into the box for this long throw, here with 5.5 minutes to play. It's a long throw looking for the head of Fournier. And looks like there's a foul called in the box, and it'll be a free kick for the Crusaders. And no Kendrick tells his team, get up, with 5 minutes to play. And he'll send the ball forward for the Crusaders. Fournier with the header clear. And headed back by Huber. And now Shane Kernan will win the ball for the Lions, and he'll continue to maintain possession as he finds his center back, Joel Copes. Bajrami driving up on the left side. He finds Kean Walder. Blakely given away, and now Angel Miranda clears. Gareth Green running onto it, and Joel Copes looks like he will let the ball roll out of play for a throw in. Fournier. Cronin sends the ball long on the left side, looking for Harrison Wright, and it's a great ball on the left side. Harrison Wright with the ball in, and it'll go over Noah Kendrick's goal, and it'll be a goal kick with 4 minutes to play here in Tigerville. North Greenville still up 2-1 and are trying to hang on to this lead to go 2-1 on the season, as the referee will stop play, and it looks like another substitution will come in. So here's the ensuing goal kick from Noah Kendrick. Harrison Wright sends the ball forward and finds David Cake. And now Chica now finds Santana. And now Harrison Wright wins it back, and he finds Will Fraser Gray. Wright again. Bajrami with the ball in. And no, Kendrick stumbled for a second, but he does well to recover his lines and claims the ball comfortably in the air for the Crusaders here with 3 minutes to go. Kendrick finds Brad Jennings, who sends the ball long and finds Henao Chica. Fournier with the clearance, and he finds Will Fraser Gray on the left side. Fraser Gray taking on David Cake. Gets a ball in the box, and it's cleared away by Sam James, and David Cake is there again to find Angel Miranda, who clears the ball for the Crusaders. Here's Bajrami. Will Fraser Gray. Blakely. Here's Harrison Wright. Harrison Wright with a shot, and it's a comfortable save, but an important save by Noah Kendrick. And he tells his teammates to get forward for this next attack for the Crusaders. And a little update on that substitution for North Greenville a minute ago. Dylan Erkins just came into the game, the goal scorer of the second goal for the Crusaders off that corner by Jorge Henao Chica. So he comes into the game for the left back, Michael Lamb. Here's Miranda. Henao Chica. Gareth Green. Trying to get a shot off. And was that a foul by Bajrami? No, it's not, says the referee. And Bajrami says, referee, don't call that. Gareth Green, get up. So now Palma will send the ball forward. Harrison Wright. Plays the ball to his center back, Derek Fournier. Here's Nestares. Back to Fournier. He'll send the ball forward. And it finds the head of Sam James. No shove in the back on Connor Hall there, says the referee. And now Henao Chica trying to get the ball under control. And there's a foul call by the referee. And here's going to be the first yellow card of the game for the Crusaders, and it goes to number 22, Angel Miranda. So now another dangerous opportunity for the Emmanuel Lions with just a little over a minute to go in this Conference Carolinas game to tie the game up and send it to overtime. Luke Fitzgerald will stand over the ball for the Lions. Jorge Henao Chica is the one-man wall that Noah Kendrick sets up for this free kick. Several red targets in the box for Fitzgerald to aim at. It's a good ball in the box. Here's the header by Alejandro Nestares, and it falls straight into the hands of a grateful Noah Kendrick. And now Noah Kendrick will put the ball forward, and it's a good ball that nearly found the feet of Jorge Henao Chica, but it does find the feet of Alejandro Bajrami, who looks for Will Fraser Gray. Gray taking on Brad Jennings, and now the clearance by David Cake comes about. Henao Chica to Gareth Green. And now he's in on goal, but the referee on the assistant referee called what looked like a handball because Gareth Green was not in an offside position, but it looked like from the pass from Connor Hall, Gareth Green took a touch and the ball deflected off of his hand, and it led to the ensuing free kick that the referee called. So now, with 30 seconds to go, Manuel has a chance now to get the ball forward and possibly tie this game. Here's Shane Cronin. Sends the ball long. Looking for options in the box. He does find the head of Nestares and is cleared away by Dylan Erkins. And Connor Hall is still trying to keep this ball in play for the Crusaders, and he does so really well. And the ball is cleared, and now Palma is trying to get it back. 12 seconds left for the Lions to have one last chance. Kernan with the long ball forward again. And now finds the feet of Will Fraser Gray, who's in on goal. Is that a foul by Brad Jennings? Time runs out, and the referee says no penalty, and that's the game, folks. The North Greenville Crusaders hang on in this very, very exciting game, and the Crusaders, who had a 2-0 lead to start the second half, gave up a goal off of a great strike by Kian Walder, but they hang on for the victory here, and now the Crusaders go 2-1 on the season with a huge victory today with a final score of North Greenville 2, Emmanuel College 1. I'll give you guys some final stats, and that'll wrap up the broadcast. So, obviously, two goals on the game, one goal from Kaletsa Matate, and the other, in his first of the season, Dylan Erkins, and two assists recorded in the game, and both of them recorded by number 8, Jorge Henao Chica, for the Crusaders. A total of 13 shots recorded by the Crusaders and 11 from the Lions, and 8 of those shots were on target for the Crusaders and 5 were on target for the Lions. North Greenville had a total of 5 corners and 3 corners for the Lions. 2 yellow cards for Emmanuel and 1 for North Greenville. A total of 10 fouls for Emmanuel, and North Greenville had 8 fouls. Both teams got called offsides twice. And in terms of goalkeepers, Giuliano Palma made 6 saves, and senior goalkeeper for the Crusaders, Noah Kendrick, made 4 saves, adding to his tally of 197 career goals. Well, that's all for tonight, folks. Thank you for tuning in to the North Greenville Sports Network for this matchup between these awesome and amazing two Conference Carolinas teams. And as I mentioned, your final score here from Tiger.